In this video, I explain bent axis piston pump. In the last video, I explained the straight axis piston pump. Why it is straight axis? Because in that case, the driver shaft and the cylinder axis are on a straight lines. Okay. But in this case, here you see this is the shaft and this is the axis of the shaft. And here you see these cylinders are inclined at certain angles and this is the axis of the cylinders. Okay. So these axes are not same. These axes are different. That's why it is called as the bent axis piston pump. So now we understand the component of the bent axis piston pump. It consists of cylinder block with radial bores. Now here you see this is the cylinder block. Okay. And inside the cylinder block, various hole is provided and this hole is called as the bore. And this bore or a holes are in a axis of the cylinder. Here you see this is the axis of the cylinder. Okay. And parallel to this axis, the holes are created. That is called as the axial bore. So here you see this is the two holes or a bores are provided. Piston are inserted in this bore. So here you see this is the piston. Here name is given piston. These pistons are inserted in these bores or a hole. Okay. So one end of the piston is inside the bore and another end of the piston is connected to the shoe plate with the shoe joints, means it is the spherical joints. Okay. Now here the shoe plate is not mentioned in this figure, but shoe plate and the flange are together. That's why here the separately shoe plates are not mentioned. Another component here you see this is the universal joint that joint the this flange and the cylinders. This is the driver shaft and this is the flange, and this flange is connected to the cylinders by using these universal joints. This is the cylinder block that we already discussed, piston. This is a pump body that outer part is called as the body. Here you see this is the valve plates and this is the port plates. This is the inlet ports and this is the outlet. Means suction is taken from this side and the discharge is taken from this bore. In a bent axis piston pump is shown in a figures, the shoe plate is fixed to a flange and the flange is keyed to a driver shaft. Means shoe plate and the flange are together and the flange is keyed to a driver shaft. Means we know that the flange and the shaft are connected by using the key joints. That's why here the key word is mentioned. The flange is keyed to a driver shaft. Means one slot is made on the driver shaft and these flange are fitted on these slots. Okay. You already study in a machine design subject what is the various types of the joints. What are the various types of the key. The axis of cylinder block and flange are intersecting at an angles. Means here you see that's are intersecting at a certain angles. Okay, that's are not in a straight line. That's why its name is given the bent axis piston pump. A universal link couple the flange and the cylinder block. Means this universal joint is coupled the flange and the cylinder. Couple means they are joined. Means universal joint is joined the cylinder block and the flange. So instance of these couple words, we also mentioned this word that the universal joint is joined the flange and the cylinder blocks. When the shaft is rotated, it causes the cylinder block to rotate. Means here you see that when the shaft is start to rotate, the shaft is rotated the flange. Okay, the flange is rotated, this universal joint is also rotated, and universal joint is rotated, that means the cylinder block is rotates. Okay, and the shoe plate will also rotate with it and causing the pistons in the bore to reciprocate. Means when the cylinder block is start to rotates, okay. When the cylinder block is start to rotate, the piston is start to reciprocate inside this hole or a bore. And when the piston is start to reciprocate, the suctions and delivery is to start from the suction ports and the delivery ports. Okay. Half rotations of the cylinder block cause the suction of oils into a bore and the next half rotation is cause the discharge. So from this side, the suction is takes place and from this side, discharge is takes place. For a half rotation, suction is carried out and for the half rotation, the discharge is carried out. There are 8 or a 12 number of such bores which are continuously performing the suction and discharge in a proper order. Proper order means there is a, suppose the 8 hole is there, out of 8 in a 2 suction is going on at the different times. Okay, means for a 0 degree in a 2 stroke suction is going on and After 60 or a 45 degree, in a two-stroke delivery is going on, in a two-stroke the suction is going on, that is the proper order is decided. Hence the pump discharge is smooth and continuous. Suppose we used only the 2 bar, so we know that we are not able to achieve the continuous discharge. For we need to achieve the continuous discharge and the smooth discharge, we need to use the number of valves, and the suction and discharge is going on in a proper order, then and then we are able to achieve the smooth and continuous discharge. Now if you understand something or learn something from this video, then I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP and other subject of the mechanical engineering. For the OHP, the various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a cards. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist, and don't forget to share with your friends.